Hi friends, hope you are doing great. Today we are going to see about the transfer service demo. In our previous video we have seen the demo, that is, this is continue video only, so we will see that video now. We will see the demo, transfer service demo right now. So I am going to create two buckets. So already I have created two buckets and I have done it, but I didn't delete that one. In this video we are going to see how to delete also. Okay, no need to worry. So if you are not seen my previous video, you just see that video. After that you have to see this video also, then only you can understand this. Okay, fine, let's create the cloud storage bucket. Let me create the cloud storage bucket with the name I am giving, like HOID 588. Just click continue. Okay, just click create now. So I have created the bucket right now, HOID, and again I am going to create one more bucket, HOID 588 2. Okay, just continue, just click create now. Yes, we have successfully created two buckets. One is 588 and one more is this one. Okay, so this is 588 582. What I am going to do means I am going to upload some files. I am going to upload some files here, and yeah, only one file only I am going to upload. This file, you can see this image Google, and it with some car, like that image we are uploading in this bucket. Yes, it has been uploaded successfully, and I am going to upload in this bucket also. This is another bucket. I am going to upload files. I am going to upload the same file only. This is for training purpose, so I like to cover one point, so that's what. Okay, so we have successfully uploaded in two buckets, but same file only we have uploaded it. Okay, let's see that one. Then we are going to see the data transfer service cloud. So I am going fast only because in our previous video we have seen these things, so that's what I am going fast. Create transfer service job, I am creating this, and the cloud storage bucket. Let me select the source bucket, and then click next step, and here just select the destination bucket, 588. Okay, just next step, and here only we should consider, we should concentrate on here. This point only I would like to explain it, when to over it. Okay, A to Z. I'm sorry. So when to overwrite if different. So for example, if you are giving this if different, and here I am giving delete files from the source after they are transferred, click next step, and run now is run now only. Just click create now. Let's see the result. Okay, let's wait for that. It's running right now, it is in progress. So the status should come like success. Let's wait for it. This is ID, it is coming like that. In my previous video I didn't delete the bucket, I didn't delete this transfer service also. So in this video we are going to do everything we are going to do. So it's running right now. Yeah, sorry, it came success. Latest run status is, it is success, it came. Okay, then what we are going to do means we are going to see in our cloud storage bucket. So in that cloud storage, if you are seeing, this is our source bucket, this is destination bucket, right? So let's check in source bucket. See friends, the source bucket, in the source bucket the files has not been deleted, even we have selected right that one option in the transfer job, but the file has not been deleted. Why means the both are same files, then it's not deleted. Okay, so I will check the, I will show that one again, why we have sell, what is the configuration we have selected. Okay, just click this transfer service, this one, and here we have the option called configuration. Just click this configuration. Here we can edit it also. Here we have selected delete files from source after they are transferred also, but this action has not been performed. Why means here we should select, instead of if different, we should select always. Just click save now. Let's wait for it. Advanced transfer options updated for upcoming transfers. So then I'm going to run that again. I'm going to run this. So here we have the option called start a run. Just click this start a run. Again it is running now. So now what it will do means we have in source bucket and destination packet same file only. Both are same file only, but it has to be overwrite. In the source bucket, the file will be deleted if we run this one. Okay, so it is in progress only. Let's wait for it. Let's wait for it. 0B to 1.5B MB transferred. Now 100% success it came, but here it's not coming. In progress only it is showing. Let's wait for it. Yeah, we got the success now. Then if you are going to see in our cloud storage source bucket, definitely the file will be the image will be deleted in this source bucket. This is our source bucket 5W2. Now see friends, the here the file has been deleted. If you see in the destination bucket, already it is available only. So no, yeah, it came now. If you are seeing the destination bucket, this image is coming. So that's what we are selecting that option always. In my previous video, I told I will do it later. Okay, next I am going to do one more thing. What I am going to do means we are going to use this option transfer here the same, right? If different options like that, let me click this one. Let me click it, click the configuration, just click edit it here. And here we have the one more option, if different, override destination file if source file with the same name is different, if files e tags or checksums don't match. So this thing we are going to do, just click this if different and click save now. So just we need to do some modification here. In cloud storage, what we have to do means in under the cloud storage, go to the cloud storage. Yes, go to the cloud storage. So here there are no files, and here 5W8. So the file is, I'm deleting this file. Okay, just delete this file. Just delete. It is deleting now. Okay, done. So now this is the source file, right? What I'm going to do means I'm going to upload one files here. So open the source bucket. So here I'm going to upload one file. Just click upload files here, and I'm going to upload this file. Okay, this image is Google. Yeah, this I'm going to upload this file. This is source bucket. This is source bucket. We have successfully uploaded, I guess. It is uploading. Yeah, we have successfully uploaded it. Then go to that destination bucket. So here what we have to do, just see friends. So here what I am going to do means I am going to open the file, and this file only we uploaded it, right? And this file, this is different. Okay, this file we have uploaded in source bucket. This file is different. What I am going to do means I am going to rename this and copy this, and I'm going to paste it in Google Docs, and again I'm going to open file. I'm going to delete from my desktop, and here I'm going to replace this name. So just put B, then cancel, and here we have to upload the files. Okay, but both are the content is different, but the file name is same only. Am I right? The file name is same, but the content inside the content, which is different. That's what we have done. Let me check that one. This is source bucket. So if you are seeing 710.454.448. So if you are seeing in the destination bucket, 710.454.48. Yeah, we have done it. Then what I'm going to do now, just check it friends. We have in the source bucket, we have this file. Okay, let me check in configuration, then you can see. Actually it will come. Okay, no problem. So I'm opening this file, and if you are seeing, clicking preview, then you can see this. So this is in source bucket. Okay, let me check in destination bucket. I'm going to the destination bucket. So here if you are seeing, just click this, and just click preview. This is different one, but this name is same only. The file name is same. Okay, now we'll go to the transfer service, transfer service, and we are going to run the job. So just edit this one. So I am not creating again, so just I'm going to edit it only. Just go to the configuration, and here we are selecting if different, override destination file if source file with the same name is different. Example, if files etax or checksums don't match, then delete files from source after they are transferred. Now just click submit. It is taking some time. Okay, done. So now we need to run this, right? So I am going to this again. I am going to click this starter run. Let's see. Let's wait for it, friends. Let's wait for it. It is in progress only. It is performing now. The task is performing now. Let's wait for it. It is performing now. Yes, it came, I guess. Oh no, it is in progress only. The status is in progress only. Let's wait for it. We have the option past run or cancel run. We can do whatever. 100% progress it came, but still data is transferring. We don't have the refresh button here. Yes, success came. Let's check in Google Cloud Storage bucket. This is source bucket. Okay, see friends, there are no files. Okay, in the existing destination bucket, you can see only one file has been uploaded. It has been overwritten, right? Just click this Google, it will come. Yeah, fine. So it has been overwritten. Okay, so now what I'm going to do means I'm going to delete each and everything. So first we will remove this bucket, after that we will remove the transfer job. Just select here and delete it here. Just type delete, that's it. Caps, it's coming, right? Confirm deletion by deleting. We should update deletion in caps. Yeah, we have successfully deleted the bucket, and we are going to delete the data transfer also. So just click this one, and here we have the option delete a job. So just click delete, and here we have to type copy paste this number ID. So just confirm deletion by typing it automatically as name. Okay, just click delete, it will delete now. Successfully we have completed the transfer service. If you have not seen my previous video about the transfer service concept and demo part one, then you can watch that video, friends. So okay, if you have not subscribed my YouTube channel, you can subscribe my YouTube channel, so that it will motivate me to upload more videos about the Google Cloud platform. Thanks a lot. Have a great day. Bye.